2D platformers have long since been a gaming staple. Luckily, it's easy to get started building one in Godot. In this video, you'll see how you can make a platformer character equipped with a double jump. We'll also brush over how to play the right animation as the character moves around. As in our previous video, we use a kinematic body 2D. Unlike with a rigid body, it lets us decide how the movement should feel and is ideal for tight player controls. In a new scene, we create a kinematic body 2D node with a collision shape and a sprite. We'll replace the sprite with an animated character once we're done with the movement code. We use a collision shape that roughly matches the character's sprite. Common shapes for characters are rectangle shape 2D and capsule shape 2D. Using a capsule makes our character slide off terrain edges because of its round ends. A rectangle avoids this. After adding a script to the kinematic body, we first define constants we'll use in the move and slide method. Up direction helps Godot know when the character is on the floor, a wall, or ceiling. You can change this value and the gravity to allow players to walk on walls. The next variables control the movement. Speed is how fast the character moves horizontally. We have the jump strength, how many times the character can jump in a short amount of time mid-air, and the strength of gravity on our character. We need to keep track of how many jumps the character has made and its current velocity. As our character needs to collide with other physics bodies, we write the movement code in the physics process function. Each frame, we get the player's horizontal movement input. This is a value between -1, when the character moves fully to the left, and 1, when it moves to the right. We can move our character using one of the move and slide functions of the kinematic body. That function takes a velocity and a couple of other parameters, and greatly simplifies character movement code. We calculate the character's velocity by multiplying the horizontal direction and speed. Vertically, we apply the gravity to pull the character down to the ground. We let the move and slide method handle moving our kinematic body 2D and collisions. It takes the velocity and the up direction. With this, the character slides along the floor. To jump or play the right animation at any given moment, we need to know if the character is on the ground, mid-air, and so on. Here's how you can get some key information about your kinematic body's state, which we store into explicit variables to make their purpose clearer in this video. We know the character is falling if it's moving towards the ground and isn't on the floor. If the player just pressed the jump button and the character is on the floor, we know it should start jumping. In the same way, it started double jumping if the player tries to jump while the character is falling. When the player releases the jump button, they've cancelled the jump. Both the idle and running states occur when the character is on the floor, but depend on the horizontal movement. With all these variables, we have everything we need to complete our character's movement and play animations. When the character jumps, we increment jumps made and set the vertical velocity. The double jump is similar, but we apply a weaker jump strength if the character hasn't hit the maximum jumps. When cancelling the jump, we set the velocity to 0 and let the gravity take over. This cuts the jump short and pulls the character down, giving more control to the player. Finally, we reset the jumps made if the character is idle or running, so it can jump again. To add animations to our character, we created a separate scene that acts as a pivot for the sprites. This pivot allows us to flip all the sprites by negating the root node scale on the horizontal axis. For this character, we had multiple sprites and created animations for different actions like running and falling. In the character scene, we replace the sprite child with this animated version. We store a reference to the scene and its animation player, as well as the starting scale so we can preserve it when we flip the sprites. To flip the sprites, we grab the sign of the horizontal movement. The value is 1 when the character moves right, and -1 when it moves left. Finally, we play the animation based on the current state of the character, and we're done! Our character can jump, double jump, and in general, feels pretty good. If you liked the video, you'll surely like our course Learn to Code from Zero with Godot. We're on Kickstarter right now to create a complete learning path and open source app to help you become a game developer. During the campaign, you can get the course at half the final price, but be quick, the Kickstarter only lasts until October 31st. Be creative, have fun, and we hope to see you in tomorrow's video.